goes for that right uppercut.
That right uppercut put Willie Featherstone away.
Last November. Right, and Burks' last title offense.
Here, that fight here in Bismarck as well.
See there, Chess, just lunging and off balance.
Good left to the midsection.
Yeah, good left hook counter punch by Virgil. That's a punch that he throws just very naturally, and he's been using it more. Eddie Funch is trying to make that a really important part of his arsenal.
Virgil Hill, not only a converted southpaw fighter, but a southpaw in everything that he does.
Again, the Chess jab finding a home. I mean, he scored with it. You saw Bobby Chess keep his right arm, his elbow tucked in very hard to his side that time. He expected the left hook counterpunch to the body, and he picked it off. But that's made his head even more vulnerable to the left hook to the head. Made his head even more vulnerable.
Inside the last 30 seconds here in the ninth round.
You know, Chess is getting home with that jab right now. I think if he would use it more, because good jab by Virgil. And a good right behind it.
We're scheduled for 9 minutes more. We'll return to Bismarck in a minute. 9 minutes of boxing remain. And for Bobby Chess, that means he has 9 minutes to try to take Virgil Hill out. Because by our unofficial scorecard, he needs a knockout to win this fight.
Tommy Parks told Bobby in the corner between rounds about the jab. The jab was working. Bobby's tried a couple of them. The jab at this point of the fight, Dan, is not designed to score points. It is designed to open up knockout punch opportunities. It's just designed to create openings.
One of the things that Virgil Hill, his trainer Freddie Roach, and Eddie Funch have been telling us is about the conditioning program that he's been on. And Alex, I'm extremely impressed with the condition of Virgil Hill. Still moving well, looks in total command of this fight, and he's in fine shape.
A lot of Virgil's confidence comes from the fact that he feels he's always in better condition than the opponent. He's not, you know, fresh as a daisy right now, man. I mean, I don't think anybody would be in round 10 of a fight, which has involved, I'm not saying a tremendous pace, but right. He fought every round. He took the last round off a little bit. Did enough, I think, to win it.
Keeping Chess at bay with the left jab.
That's what Bobby needs to do. Couldn't sustain it, but that's exactly what he needs to do.
And even if he pays the price for going in like that, he has no choice. And Bobby Chess, enough of a ring veteran to know that he's got to gamble. Something he's not afraid to do.
Well, again, right here, Bobby. This is a good sequence right here to start a round 10 for Bobby Chess. This, once again, is trading. Virgil Hill is effective in landing effective punches also. But this really is the only chance Chess has.
And for the first time this fight, Virgil Hill standing in the center of ring.
For the first time, at least since round 3.
And then he stood there then because he was hurt.
Even before that, he was less mobile than he has been in the round since.
This is the 10th round. Bobby Chess on the left, trying to make something big happen.
You see him looking to time Virgil, looking, waiting for the Virgil punch to try to counter it. That time he made Virgil miss. Oh, good right hand lead by Virgil Hill.
This is the end of round number 10. A lot of the crowd here at the Bismarck Civic Center on their feet during the last break between rounds, cheering on Virgil Hill, who they know is in command of this fight as the 11th round gets underway. Bobby Chess in the gold sequin shoes.
And he's doing something right now that's a classic mistake. He's trailing Virgil Hill around the ring. He isn't cutting it off. He's not beating Virgil to the spot.
The point about the gold clearly slowed down in this round, allowing Chez to wade in and hit it.
Well, Virgil's taken a lot of punishment in this fight, perhaps more than he's ever taken in his professional career.
Oh, and a low blow that time. Virgil Hill got one in on Bobby Chez.
Even the hometown crowd oohed about him.
They're a sophisticated fight crowd here in Bismarck.
You know something, Danny, I was going to say earlier, it's very easy for us to sit here at ringside and say what Bobby Chez has to do. It's pretty obvious right now, I think, that an old 27 as he is, his body just won't do it. He knows what he has to do. His body just will not do it.
How much of it is that left jab in the footwork of Virgil Hill? It's not an easy target.
Well, it's definitely a factor. Yeah, three good punches, but arm punches. They weren't real hard punches by Chez.
Virgil Hill coming out of the corner, doing a little body movement to let Bobby Chez know that he didn't hurt him. We've got 3 minutes of boxing left. And Virgil Hill walks over to his corner with a smile on his face and wiggles his eyebrows. And let's take a look at some action here, Alex, from the last round.
I think this is the left hook that clearly landed low by Virgil Hill there in round 11.
The referee screened from that shot, so he did not intervene and make a comment on it.
You just saw Virgil Hill tell Eddie Futch, "I'm going to go to him." He has clearly been caught up in the emotion of this crowd. He's well ahead on the scorecard. And he wants to impress not only them, but all the people in the boxing world and the sports world. Look at him. They're trying to talk him out of it.
Look at the determination on the face of the champion, Virgil Hill. There are 8,500 people here in Bismarck on their feet, and their man is pumped.
Freddie Roach and Eddie Futch were desperately trying to talk Virgil Hill out of doing what he said he was going to do and into the smart thing, which is to stay away, which he's doing right now. But you saw, as you pointed out, Dan, the determination, the single-mindedness, the focus of Virgil Hill.
Bismarck has seen what they came to see. Maybe they would have preferred a knockout, but that's not one of Virgil Hill's specialties. Boxing, counter-punching, movement. He's given it all to them today, and to Bobby Chez as well.
It's also obvious that, good left hook by Virgil, a little bit extended.
Virgil Hill, in the middle of the ring, wants to slug it out with Bobby Chez.
A showboating Virgil Hill, which is totally away from his character. He's the quietest guy outside the ring. Very, very humble. Gives credit to everybody else but himself. But every once in a while, he gets swept up.
I admire his emotions, Alex. I admire his competitiveness. I'm just not sure how smart this is, but Bobby Chez is capable of putting him away with that big right.
I don't think so. At this stage, whether Bobby could put him away. I think he might be able to hurt him. I don't think he can put him away. It's not a chance worth taking at the point.
Absolutely right. It's not a chance.
He doesn't want to find out. And also, we should point out, with a little more than a minute left in this round, that despite what Virgil said, except for a few flurries like that, this one, he has moved and he has jabbed. And really, he has fought this 12th round just the way he should tactically.
The only time Virgil Hill was in trouble, he was knocked down in the third round. It was not ruled a knockdown, ruled a slip. And he was shaky after that, but Bobby Chez not able to do anything with it. Ever since then, it's been all Virgil Hill. Seconds left in this fight. A solid chance. as they roar their approval.
I think you can see from the reaction of Robert Hill, Virgil's father there, he did not like seeing Virgil in that much trouble in round three. That was more excitement than he wanted.
Well, it's pandemonium here in Bismarck, North Dakota. Their home state guy, Virgil Hill, attempting to retain his title. We'll be back for the decision here in Bismarck. But right now, how about if we go back to Florida, Gulfstream Park, and here's Jim McKay. Without delay, let's go up to the ring and get the announcement from Michael Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is the official scoring. Eva Shane scores the bout 117 to 111. Richard Strange has it 119 to 110. And Medrado Villalobos scores it 117 to 112. Before the winner, and still, Virgil Quicksilver.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Very one-sided scorecards. Was it a tougher fight than the scorecards indicated?
Yep, definitely. Bobby Chess come in shape. You know, he didn't let up. Very strong, great body puncher. Had him frustrated a little bit, but...
Were you hurt in round three?
Yep.
Yep. Was it a knockdown?
Yeah.
Yeah, he rolled it a slip, but I thought you were clearly down.
Right on the chin, and good thing they didn't give it to him. But
Virgil, late in the fight, you seemed to go a little bit flat-footed trying to impress. Was that because you were a little tired, or were you just trying to impress people?
No, we tried to switch it up a little bit, you know, and couldn't move all the time. We had to tire him out. Because me just moving around the ring was not getting him tired. Right. And so that's what we, you know.
Virgil, thanks very much. Congratulations. Thank Good luck. Bobby, can I talk to you just briefly?
Sure.
One quick question, Bobby. It seemed like a case of you knowing what to do, but your body just wasn't able to do it.
Well, you know, we've been training a long, long time, and he's a little quicker than I thought. I was a split second slower than I wanted to be. I thought the knockdown was clean. It was a clean right hand. He went
Virgil
down.
Said it was.
And that'll attest to it. But I had him early, and maybe the knockdown actually hurt me because he speeded up, and I got a little excited, and I lost my timing by a split second. And, you know, he's a little quicker than I thought. His lateral movement was excellent. But I thought the fight was closer than that.
Bobby, I'm really sorry. I'm going to have to cut you short. I'm sorry. We're short on time.